Rarely has the great divide between the rich and the poor been so wide or so concerning.
There's new evidence tonight that it's even contributing to serious, perhaps fatal, health complaints. Zoe Ford joins us from Fairfield tonight. Zoe, it's not good news for residents there, is it?
Bill, the latest census data tells us that out of all the suburbs in Sydney, Fairfield has the highest rate of diabetes and heart disease. And some of the other areas out here in the west are not that far behind. They're low socioeconomic areas. There's a high migrant population, an Indigenous population. And of course, everyone is ageing. So all of that has the Diabetes Council very concerned.
When Don Marsh was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, then had a heart attack, he thought it was all downhill.
Devastated, actually.
But the Western Sydney retiree has learned to live with the disease, just like thousands of others around him.
The areas in red are the areas where there's the highest number of people with diabetes and the highest rates.
The new research has found where diabetes is common, so too is heart disease. And the hotspots are all poorer areas in the west. Fairfield has the most sufferers. Holroyd is next, followed by Bankstown, Canterbury and Parramatta. Least at risk are central Sydney and the wealthy suburbs of the North Shore.
Obviously, you can't just give people lots of money or transplant them throughout the city. We've got to think about how we can improve.
Is what you're doing out there enough?
I believe we're doing a lot in Western Sydney.
Is it enough?
I believe it's growing to be substantial. It was not enough.
I think a lot more can be done.
And not just through health programs.
The Diabetes Council says the infrastructure around Western Sydney is also a factor. People are spending too many hours of the day sitting in traffic, and by the time they get home at night, there's very little time or motivation to prepare a healthy meal or do some exercise.
$10 billion is the healthcare costs associated with diabetes, and I think we need to be investing a lot more.
Don believes it's up to individuals too.
You can still go out, you can still enjoy things, you can still be active. It's not the death sentence, so to speak.
It is National Diabetes Week this week, so if you do have any of the risk factors, and those are if you're overweight, if you have a family history of diabetes, if you have an ethnic background, it's a good idea to go and see your doctor. And while you ponder all of that, consider this. Every day in Australia, 290 people develop diabetes, and one person is diagnosed with the disease every 5 minutes.
OK, Ms. Zoe, thank you.